Well, it looks like I got the exhaust problem solved. It took a little bit of creative grinding and removing of casting flash on the block and on the transmission. And also I had to do a little blacksmithing on this pipe and cut and change an angle a little bit, but as you can see, it's not touching the transmission. And this pipe and the manifold had to be connected together first and then put on as an assembly. The flange for the downpipe, had to redo this part, this little bracket, and clearance it a little bit there. But basically, downpipe goes on just where it would on the factory engine. And I don't have any bolts for that because I kind of destroyed the old ones. Put new insulation and aluminum wrap on the exhaust system. Had to do a little work on that exhaust pipe right there to get clearance with the transmission. And yeah, that's it. The exhaust system is complete. Also, I got a new throttle valve cable. It's longer and reaches there. Actually, it's too long. I may have to shorten it a little bit. That was spec'd out for a Chevy pickup with a 700R4 transmission. So yeah, I made some good progress today. And I'm happy about the exhaust. I wasn't sure how that was going to turn out. Another thing I did, I got the battery tray mounted on the other side now, right side. This came from a 90-something Chevy pickup and had this tab on it. Just drilled a hole and put a little J-clip in there. Put this piece on the bottom, and there were two holes in the body already for J-clip, so that's solid. And I put some Pour 15 on the rust down here and sprayed some white over it. The same thing over there where the battery used to be. Well, I got a little bit more done today. Friend came over, and so I was busy talking with him, and I didn't video much, but I got the valve covers painted. I got this bracket taken off, and the holes welded up. The same for the rear one. And I got the alternator rebuilt. Needed some diodes, and I couldn't resist painting the stator the color of the valve covers. All the tube lines painted black, the ones that are going to be black. Stuff down there, and I got the transmission dipstick put in place. Also got the throttle body rebuilt. As you can remember from earlier, it didn't have any injectors, so got all the injectors in there. New fuel regulator diaphragm, all that kind of stuff. So tomorrow, I plan to move on to overhauling the compressor and steering pump. So those are the two last things I believe that are going to keep me from putting it in the car, is the steering pump and compressor. I want to get those done before it goes in. Also, if you remember, there used to be a single line coming from here that went for the map sensor signal. Now I've got a T and a double line, because the transmission modulator has to have a signal from the manifold plenum. One thing about a draw-through system, you're creating a fuel air mixture here, and then you're compressing it in the compressor going into the engine. So this has got a pre-mixed fuel air mixture in it. So everything connected to that has to be basically fuel line. This is all brass and steel tubing. But the fitting from that to the map sensor will be fuel line with clamps, and the same for this to the modulator, because if that leaks, it will be a highly combustible pre-mixed fuel air mixture. It'll be like if ignited, it would be like a blowtorch. So you don't want to run any like boost gauge lines into the car from a draw through. If you wanted a boost gauge, you'd probably want to use an electric one. Leave the transducer outside under the hood so that you wouldn't route any air fuel mixture into the car.